हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सेकेंड टर्म सिलेबस लेसन 3 वाटर बॉडीज। यू नो दैट योर फर्स्ट टर्म सिलेबस इज ओवर एंड वी आर स्टार्टिंग द सेकेंड टर्म सिलेबस फ्रॉम लेसन 3 वाटर बॉडीज। ए बॉडी ऑफ वाटर और वाटर बॉडी इज एनी सिग्निफिकेंट accumulation of water on the earth's surface. The earth is often called the watery planet because 71% of its surface is covered nearly with water. The term often refers to oceans, seas and lakes, rivers, streams, canals and other geographical features where water moves from one place to another are also considered bodies of water. The Earth's hydrosphere consists of water on and below the surface of the Earth. The oceans account for 71% of the Earth. Unlike continents, all oceans and seas are interconnected. The changing states of water is the hydrological cycle. It refers to the circulation of water within the Earth's atmosphere, hydrosphere and lithosphere in different forms, that is liquid, solid and gaseous state. Now, I am going to teach you about the oceans. The oceans are the base of the hydrological cycle. Generally, we speak of the oceans as if they are separate bodies of water. In reality, they are just sections of one great sea covering most of the Earth's surface. The major oceans of the world are Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and Southern Ocean. Now, first and the largest ocean, that is Pacific Ocean. It is the largest ocean and deepest ocean covering 1/3 of the globe. Its average depth is 4,572 meters. Its basin contains high and abrupt ridges, deep trenches, volcanic mountains, and other features. Pacific Ocean has a string of volcanoes along the coastal margins of the continent. The deepest trench on the earth is the Mariana Trench, which is 11,022 meters deep, which is located in the western Pacific Ocean. Pacific is a Spanish word meaning peaceful sea. It was named so by a Portuguese explorer, Ferdinand Magellan. Now the second largest ocean, that is Atlantic Ocean. Atlantic Ocean is the second largest ocean. It is located between North America and South America in the west and Africa and Europe in the east. Many rivers drain into ocean, such as the Rhine, Senegal, Niger, Congo, Amazon, Mississippi, Orinoco, and La Plata. Atlantic Ocean is the great commercial highway of the world. Most of the world's greatest ports lie on its coast. Atlantic Ocean occupies an elongated S-shaped basin extending longitudinally. The ocean's name was derived from Greek mythology, meaning Sea of Atlas. It is the saltiest major ocean. Now the third largest ocean, that is Indian Ocean. Indian Ocean is comparatively small in size with an average depth of 4000 meters. The two great bays on either side of the peninsula of India, that is the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea, belong to the Indian Ocean. The Indian Ocean has thousands of small islands like Maldives and Cocos Islands. Mauritius Islands are volcanic islands. It is bounded by Asia in the north, Africa in the west, and Australia in the east. It facilitates trade and travel between the eastern and western countries. The principal rivers draining in the Indian Ocean are Zambezi, the Indus, the Ganga, and the Irrawaddy. Its deepest point is the Sunda Deep of the Java Trench of the southern coast of the island of Java in Indonesia, which is 7,450 meters deep. Now the fourth largest ocean, which is Arctic Ocean. It is the smallest of all the oceans. It is situated round the North Pole and remains perpetually frozen. In the south, it is bounded by Europe and Asia, and it is the northernmost ocean in the world. Arctic Ocean is the in salinity, it is very low. It is important due to introduction of polar air routes between Europe and North America. It is not navigable. It is surrounded by important continents of Europe, North America, and Asia. Arctic Ocean's surface temperature and salinity vary seasonally as the ice cover melts and freezes. Now the smallest ocean of the world, that is the Southern Ocean, which is the combination of all the southern oceans, that is Indian Ocean, the Antarctic Ocean, and the Pacific Ocean. The Antarctic or Southern Ocean surround the continent of Antarctica in the southern hemisphere. It is an extension of the Pacific, Atlantic, and Indian Oceans. It remains frozen for most parts of the year, and hence it is not navigable. It is larger than Arctic Ocean. By way of his voyages in the 1770s, Captain James Cook proved that water encompassed the southern latitudes of the globe. Since then, geographers have disagreed on the Southern Ocean's northern boundary or even existence, considering it to be an extension of the Pacific, Atlantic, and Indian Ocean. So, I am now the importance of oceans, how oceans are important to us. The oceans of Earth serve many functions, especially affecting the weather and temperature. They moderate the Earth's temperature by absorbing the incoming solar radiation stored as heat energy. The ever-moving ocean currents distribute this heat energy around the globe. This heats the land and air during winter and cools it during summer. Oceans are of immense use to man. They are useful in many ways, directly and indirectly. They not only play a significant role in the climate of adjoining countries, but serve mankind in many ways. They are a storehouse of several resources. They serve as important waterways. Man has been exploiting ocean resources for centuries. Source of water. Ocean is a major source of water to mankind through water cycle. Oceans contribute water vapors to atmosphere, and we get the same in the form of precipitation. Then climate. Oceans have direct control over climate. Nearness to oceans is an important factor of climate. Various elements of climate like temperature, rain, humidity, etc. are affected by nearness to oceans. Oceans act as thermoaccumulator or bank of heat. That is, they store heat and release when neighboring land gets cold. They modify the climate of coastal areas through ocean currents. Then the food resources. The oceans are the biggest storehouse of edible forms of marine food. Fish being most important. Millions of people in the world take fish as their food. In addition to food, sea animals provide other products like oil, glue, cattle feed, etc. Seaweed is used to prepare food. Seaweed is an important part of diet of the Japanese. Then mineral and chemical resources. Oceans have enormous mineral and chemical wealth. A variety of dissolved salts like sodium chloride, common salt, magnesium chloride, potassium chloride, etc. are found in plenty. Oceans and oil. Oil and gas are important fuels obtained from oceans. More than 100 countries at present are extracting oil and gas from continental shelves of oceans. A large part of world's oil production comes from offshore fields. Bombay High is an important offshore oil producing area of India. Oceans and energy. Oceans are becoming a source of energy also. Some developed countries like France, UK, USA, etc. are generating energy from tides. Trade and transport. Oceans provide cheapest mode of transportation for international trade. Ocean routes are very useful for trade and transportation of bulky products like coal, iron, machinery, transport equipment, etc. Ocean routes act as highways for trade, though there are some obstacles like fog, icebergs, coral reefs, storms, etc. Yet oceans remain as highways of trade and travel. Now, I am concluding this topic, and the next topic I will teach you about the seas and types of seas and distribution of sea in the world and about lakes and rivers. So thank you for today and watch the next video.